What are the rules? What are you judging? What are the rules? What are you expecting? Are the rules the same as when Len was here, or is it different? Is this a ballroom competition, or is this not? Like, right. It's simple.
It's the end of the road for AJ McLean and Cheryl Burke on Dancing with the Stars.
I already had his other two routines choreographed for the semifinals, you know? Like, that's how, and normally I'm not that confident going in. Like, I never want to be, but, you know, I was like, oh, for sure, there's no way.
Yeah, Cheryl, she's straight up shocked.
AJ and Cheryl are eliminated. I am so sorry, gosh.
After 9 weeks on the hit dancing competition show, the Backstreet Boys star and his pro partner were sent home during Icons Night.
Carrie and Inaba.
7.
Derek Hough.
8.
Bruno Tonioli.
8.
It all came down to the judges' votes, and while Derek Hough chose to save them, he was beat out by Bruno Tonioli and Carrie Inaba, who both opted to save the other couple in jeopardy, Johnny Weir and Britt Stewart.
I base my decision upon the competition so far, and I have to save Johnny and Britt.
I love you both, respect you both, but I'm saving Johnny and Britt.
I don't think it's really hit me yet, to be honest.
Tomorrow, but I feel like one big hangover.
Tomorrow, yeah, it's going to be an emotional hangover for sure. But you know what? It's been an absolutely gracious journey. I'm grateful for every experience that I've endured with this amazing woman.
During the show, AJ and Cheryl paid tribute to Freddie Mercury with a Viennese waltz. And AJ made a mistake early on that the judges all jumped on, even though he recovered like a boss. Take a look in the mirror and cry. Yeah, that flub ended up earning the duo a score of 23 out of 30. The lowest score they'd had in weeks.
This is the first time we've messed up in a dance since the beginning at all. But in my honest opinion, I think the way we handled it was like a couple pros.
But Cheryl, well, she was frustrated and disappointed by that score.
There's rules in ballroom. And as far as I'm concerned, this is a ballroom show, I thought. So, but again, you know, it's just not consistent as far as, okay, so if you can't break hold in quick step, yet you're giving out perfect scores when people are breaking hold, what are the rules? Same thing with a tango. You're not supposed to break hold. I take full responsibility over most of whatever I put out there, right? Like, as far as like what I can do, as far as me being a professional ballroom dance teacher. And so with that being said, look, I do believe the judges score the celebrities against themselves. I do not think that AJ and Nelly, for example, are on the same plane. Like, absolutely not. Like, if AJ were to do what Nelly has done, they probably wouldn't give him the same score. Like, it's just, they do put people up that they think have dance experience up on different pedestals. I get it. And they just push for greatness. But what's frustrating is, I guess, not getting the thank you for having body contact when you're in frame, or maybe you should have a little. So for me, a perfect score is a perfect score, especially in a ballroom dance when you're not supposed to break hold. You better have a perfect frame with body contact. I mean, there's just rules.
As for AJ, well, he's taking it all in stride.
I've always been one, I hope, to bow out from whatever the situation is with ease and grace and with lots of gratitude. Because honest to God, you know, I've made a lot of great friends here, both on the stage and off the stage. It still sucks. It's, you know, it's a major bummer. But there's also kind of a sense of relief and calmness as well, you know, because life goes on. And my wife has been holding down the fort, man, like a trooper. Since my mother-in-law moved out, it's my wife holding down, because this is 7 days a week, every week.